Oh yeah. Pete with the 9 watts per kilogram. Hey, Bob. So Bob, we're actually enjoying a warm up here. You can see the clock in the bottom left. That's the countdown to the race. Let me know how audio levels are. What's loud, what's not. Pete had to drop out of the sky to come back to where I was. Poor guy. No, this is not the race yet. Just hanging out, loosening up. Listening to some funky, royalty-free tracks. Ah, thanks, Bob. Try to back it up. So, Bob, this other guy in black, this is Peter. He's one of the local riders out here. He's gonna ride with me tonight. Ooh, time to join the event. Pete, if you're watching, I'm gonna let this happen. To the start corral in our zebra pajamas. So, we gotta do a better job with customization here. How do I know what bike I'm on? I guess it's probably the Zwift bike. Maybe not. Maybe. Peter, do you know what kind of mountain bike we were on? I want to mess with the colors.
Ooh, is that it?
I guess not. Hang on a sec, Bob. We'll talk about that in just a second. I don't know how to do this. Maybe it's here? Yes, okay. Ah, so we're all on the sponsor's choice. Oh, there we go. Is that gold? Yeah, Pete, you're right. Okay, cool. I want to be like Kate. Okay. Okay, so Bob, an explanation of how they calculate speed. So, a couple factors. They're more or less the same factors in the real world. You have the coefficient of aerodynamic drag, just how big you are, so height matters. You have weight, and you have power. And then there's little differences from one bike to another. These are mountain bikes, so they kind of up the power required to go a given speed. And so basically, given those inputs, you know, the coefficient of drag is just estimated from your height and weight, I guess. But given those inputs, if you're putting out enough power when you approach the finish with someone who's smaller than you, you're gonna go faster than them. So that's it. But let me know if that was unsatisfactory. I'll try to talk more. Basically, Bob, a rule of thumb would be if I'm riding next to Pete on a hill, Pete's a lot less heavy than I am. So to hold the same speed, you know, elbow to elbow, nobody drafting, there's a proportional difference in the power required to do that. So it's a pretty short course tonight. We're gonna go out of the Star Corral on a downhill section, and then there's like a heavy man's climb, a not so steep climb that goes up a hill, and then we go down it, we go up it again, and then down it to the finish. It's very short. Bob, no, it's not linear. It's an exponential function. Pete, that could be. I haven't looked into this in a while. I think the last I checked, there was some indication that height mattered a little, but not nearly as much as weight. Not sure though. I mean, that could be. Could have changed. Maybe there's new info out there. Yeah, watts per kilo is the big thing, especially on hills. The steeper it gets, the more that matters. On a flat, absolute watts do matter. All right, off we go. good-sized group. Looks like over 90 riders. That's cool. Keep moving up. Hey, Matt. Geez, they're making a selection on the downhill. Who are these crazy people? Pete, was that you? Did you force that split? Look at Matt! Matt's open! Pete's throwing the cat in amongst the pigeons. Check out everybody's customized bike colors. You can dress us up in zebra pajamas, but we're gonna express ourselves. Yeah, Bob, just my old setup's not really in place. Pure gameplay this time. Okay. Entering the circuit that we're gonna lap twice. I wonder if that second group's gonna bridge up. Uh-oh. Pace is on. Thanks for that tiny draft, Pete. Great. Hey, Margar. Okay. So this is gonna split up on the hill. You can see the profile in the top right. We're halfway down the hill. We go up the other side. And there's some really strong dudes who are gonna split it on the hill. Try to stay with, but it's gonna be a tough ask. Maybe Pete can make the split. Insane pace right now. This is good. Actually, that's probably not true. Since I'm so heavy, this is probably my best chance to do damage. But it feels so good to soft pedal. Finish line simulation right here. You come down into this flat, bit of resistance on the wood, go around a couple bends on the flat, and there's the line. Ooh, everybody's resting before the hill. Not good for me. Pete, it's good to see you wearing a helmet. Safety first. Telling me there's a gap. Oh, there it is. Oh boy. Matt, it was downhill in the draft. Pete, get to the front of this group. How's it telling me to close this gap? Looks like I'm on the wheel. Ooh.
Stop attacking, fellas. Oh, baby. Hurting. Okay, I'm gonna have to settle in here. Nice to have some help. I don't want to do this on my own. Help is coming, but it's gonna blow right by me. Thanks, buddy. Nice to see you ride on before you drop someone. Almost to the top. That's the top. Anybody see where Pete ended up?
And these guys come through and pull me downhill. So we're completing one lap here, with one to go after. Laps over at the bottom of the downhill. Trying to keep the power down. I'm gonna need every watt on the way back up. Heart rate's coming down, that's good. Yeah, heart rate, drop into the 150s, do it. Oh yeah. Oh, that feels nice. Oh no! Interesting situation. This is like full-on recovery pace, but with the resistance of the mountain bike and riding on dirt, there's just no way that I have the power difference to ride away. Need the hill to be a decider. I don't know how that fast guy behind me has been climbing. Looks like we're in a worst case 12th finish. That's good. Not terrible.
better.
Trim a little weight on the climb for 15 seconds. Oop, that's not the right time to use that, buddy. Yeah, Matt, it's a good one. Arrow would have been a little better to save to the finish, but we'll take this. Why does it say I've got 4 meters? So confusing, Zwift. This is a good pace. Great, great news. Power's coming up a little bit here. There we go. Oh boy. That's not a great sign. Buddy, it's hurting.
this time. We're close. Oh boy. Stretching the legs out of the saddle. Downhill from here. Chase here. Not
sure how I went from 12th to 13th, but oh well. I found the sloth. He's got more in me. Come on. That was everything. Thanks, Matt. Oh boy. Trying to bring my heart rate down so I can talk again. Thanks, Bob. Whew.
That's great. Thanks, Margar. See if we can find Pete. Figurative win. I'll take that right now. Let's see what's going on in this group. No Pete. Dudes, that was tough. Thanks for sticking around. It's pretty motivating when the lights go out. And they always do. So, I think this event is every day. I'm not sure. It'd be really tiring, but if it is, I'll put a reminder up and we can all hang out while we hide from the virus. Alright guys, I'm gonna shut it down. Good hanging with you. See you at the next one.